L'appréhension du risque climatique s'est améliorée avec
We understand the climate risk much better now
with
the Paris Agreement and the COP21 meeting in 2015. We now understand that the climate risk is a systemic risk, a collective risk, because the forces at play in the relationship between the greenhouse effect gas concentration and climate are forces that are badly known and that cause evolutions that might be divergent. And this causes the temperature to run away with some badly known greenhouse effect gas concentration thresholds are exceeded. This is a fundamental danger made worse by the fact that temperature increase that we foresee is not homogeneous across the planet, which means that there will be migrations, populations migrating, and this will be very difficult to control. There are three types of risks, basically. The physical risk, the risk of natural disasters and extreme events, which are increasingly expensive and dangerous as the temperature rises, causing social costs that are difficult to bear. There is also the liability risk. Now, the liability risk has to do with the cost of insurance in order to help the victims of climate changes, and this will increase as the physical risk increases. And finally, there is also the transition risk, a different type of risk, which has to do with the losses incurred by the industries that produce polluting compounds. When investments are made to turn the production structure towards a low-carbon economy, these polluting industries will lose value, will lose money, and this will cause losses. Let us take the example of these two categories, physical risk and transition risk. Here we have the physical risk with a simulation of temperature increase. The heat wave in 2003 killed many people. And as you can see on the left-hand side of the graph, it only happened once since 1950. What happens if the temperature rises by 2 or 3 degrees in average? The likelihood of longer and more frequent heat wave events will increase. This will cause changes in the lifestyle, negative changes. And there are costs in the losses for polluting industry, and in some cases the losses will be substantial. Sometimes transition is difficult to achieve because the transition must lead to a complete change in our production structures, and this transition must take place slowly, progressively, so that the losses can be absorbed. But that also means that the whole regulation process must be well controlled. The Paris Agreement is the starting point. It is the starting point because the Paris Agreement goes towards a lifestyle and a growth pattern that is sustainable and inclusive. But it requires two types of investments, investments to reduce greenhouse effect gas emissions, and also investments to allow us to adapt to the changes during the transition so that the social costs of the physical risks will be easier to bear. These two characteristics are absolutely essential, and we must be able to develop the economy in that direction. However, we're far from having achieved this because the Paris Agreement led to intentions, declared intentions. The governments declared their intentions to take action. What are the effects on the course towards a lower temperature? The intentions allow to mitigate the trajectory towards higher temperatures, which would take place if nothing were done. But if you look at the green trajectory, the most important one, the one that would lead us to lock on to a trajectory for lower than 2 degrees in temperature increase and even better, better 1.5 degrees, well, these trajectories require huge investment efforts to reduce emissions, which are much greater than what is currently declared in their intentions by governments. So the problem has not yet been solved, and the problem is difficult to solve because of something known as the tragedy of the horizon. Here we have the example of the penguin community, because penguins are threatened by climate changes. What does it mean? It means that for decision makers, people who must steer the transition process, whether they are political players or financial players, well, they will be submitted to an impact. Transition will be expensive, but the cost will be immediate. Whereas, because of the inertia of climate changes, which takes time, the gains will only come in the long run. People who today take the responsibility of starting the process, and this has a cost for society, will no longer be in power when the benefits will come in a couple of decades. So it is more in their vested interest to do nothing and block the transition process. It is therefore difficult to break the tragedy of the horizon. And in order to break the strategy and stop it, especially in our democratic societies, where decisions are also directly connected with voting cycles for 5 years in a political cycle, in order to break the cycle, we have to change the role of politicians. We must introduce what we call an ethical principle, whereby future generations, their lifestyle, their survival even, will be considered as a categoric imperative, something absolutely essential in politics. And this would introduce an in-depth change versus our current habits. Once, if we can do this, if politicians become aware of the responsibilities they carry versus future generations, what will be the resources that will help them go beyond the declared intentions? The first one consists in introducing a financial, a monetary value, a social value. We need to introduce it. The market will not do it. We need to introduce it for gas, greenhouse effect gas emission reduction activities. This is essential because it will help companies or company owners who want to make that sort of investment to have a guarantee. They will have the guarantee that this will have a yield, that the investments they are going to make will yield a benefit, and the benefit will be matched with the collective gain for society. The private gain benefit for private entrepreneurs will match the collective gain for society as a whole. This would be the first pillar of the necessary reforms that we need to carry out in order to make sure that the intentions match the problems. The second thing is the need to transform the financial system, and we have to change the financial system in the following way. First of all, we need to organize a certification regarding the volume of greenhouse effect gases that we need to avoid, and this must be done by companies. And also, the certification of the volume of greenhouse effect gases must be combined with the guarantee that the credits they obtain after certification will be valid. Second thing, there will be many different credits in order to fund energy efficacy on the microeconomic level. And for investors who have savings to invest, institutional investors, to be able to act because they cannot own this kind of credit, public intermediaries must come into the play. For instance, public development banks must turn these credits into green bonds that can be bought by the institutional investors. And finally, the whole finance world transition process must be regulated by central banks. If we can achieve this, then Europe will take the leadership in a type of growth that is both sustainable and inclusive, because it would be centered on the final benefit in a few decades, a carbon neutral society where we would control climate change.